I built an AI SaaS without writing any code, and in this video, I'm going to show you how I did it. But before we get into it, I'm going to show you what the product actually is. So here it is on the user side. It's called User Chat, and it's an AI conversational form that allows companies to write questions, send the form to users, and then have the form dig deep into the user's answers to get more information than a basic form would give them. So here's an example. This is an event feedback form. So I'm going to go ahead and type yes to start the survey, and we're going to get a response from the AI. And let's go ahead and show you how it works if we respond. So I'll say, yes, I found them relevant, because the question is asking if the sessions and discussions were relevant to my interests. And we're going to say yes. So in a normal survey, that would be it. So you would just get the answer yes, but you wouldn't get anything else. So here what the AI is doing is it's asking, can I share more about why I found it useful and relevant? Were there specific topics or areas that resonated with me? So then I could say I really liked the speaker that spoke about the future of AI. And then it might probe further. So let's see what it says here. And can you describe what you found particularly interesting? So I'm not going to go on and on through this survey, but you can see how it works, where it's probing to get more detailed answers from the users. Something else that is pretty cool is you can also answer by voice. I'm not going to do that in this video because it won't work because I'm recording a video, but users can answer by voice or by text, which is pretty cool. So next I'm going to show you the backend, so the admin part of the app and the analytics, and then I'm going to tell you how I built this. So what no-code tools I used to build this, what are the different API connections that I used to build this, and you're going to learn what's possible to build with no-code and AI. And here's quickly what it looks like from the admin side. So in the survey setup itself, there's a link here to share the URL. You can change the name, the survey goal, which is helpful for generating the questions in the survey. You can choose if the default is spoken or written, and change different information and details about the survey. And then with the questions, what's cool is you can generate questions. So if I click this generate button, based on the goal of the survey, it's going to suggest different questions that we could add. And we'll just give it a second here to generate those questions. And here you can add questions if you like any of these questions. I already have them, so I'm not going to add them for now. And then there's also analysis buckets so that you can add buckets to analyze the questions afterwards. So just to show you an example, it says, what problems do you face when using the weather app? The buckets are going to bucket the responses into either usability issues, performance issues, information accuracy, and feature requests. And you can also add buckets and similarly use AI to generate buckets for you so that you don't have to do it from scratch. And lastly, you also have the ability to add an image here, which allows you to upload an image so that if you're doing usability testing, you could have an image of like your user interface that users could answer a question about. So you can add questions here. I'm going to quickly go through the other features. So the responses, you can go through and view all the responses. The AI here is going to summarize the completed responses, and you can also read the entire transcript if you'd like. Then we can go to the full report, which is going to give a full summary of all of the responses. And then here you can see the percentages of the different buckets that those responses fell into. We also have a question analysis area where you can, in more detail, get detail about the first and second question here, because we have two questions in our example. And then we also are going to pull out key user quotes from that question analysis. You also can ask anything to the data. This is pretty cool. It's kind of like a chatbot that's going to answer based on the responses. And then you can also set up email notifications both to the user who completed the survey as well as to yourself so that you know that you received a response. Now, one thing that I used to help with the design of this Bubble app is a tool called Basis. That's BASIS. It's a design framework that allows you to copy and paste design elements into your Bubble app so that you don't have to spend as much time designing it from scratch. And it also gives you a really nice look and feel, in my opinion. So that's something that I used to build this a lot more quickly. The last features that I'm going to show you that I built, here is the home screen where you can see all of the different surveys that you've created. You have a team tab where you can edit your team. You can also add credits as well. And then you can also change your settings. So basic settings that you can change and then add credits to purchase. Now I'm going to talk about how I actually built this AI SaaS app without code. So the tool that I used is Bubble, and I'm going to take you behind the scenes here of how I actually built the app in Bubble and some of the things that you would want to keep in mind if you were going to build your own AI SaaS app. So you're going to want to make sure to watch until the end so that you don't miss any of the tips and tricks that I talk about here in this part of the video. So if you're not that familiar with Bubble, you're going to want to check out some of our other videos to learn more about how to build in Bubble. But in this video, I'm just going to go over on a high level what I did here in Bubble to design this app. So first, we have our sign up page and our login page here. And again, I'm using the basis design system to very easily create these login and sign up pages. And then there's workflows here in Bubble to actually build the logic into our app. So on a high level in Bubble, you have your designer and you have your workflow. The designer is where you design the front end, what the user sees, and the workflow is where you're going to build in all of the logic. And then the database is where you're going to save all of your data that the workflows are manipulating. What I'm going to talk about now is how we actually built AI functionality into this app. So there's a couple of different plugins that I use here. So first, if we go into our API connector, we're connecting to OpenAI and we're using the ChatGPT, or that's what I called it, basically the chat completions API. We're using GPT-4 in this example. Here I have GPT 3.5 Turbo, but in the live app, we're using GPT-4. And we're using this basic functionality to send information, the chat history, to OpenAI and then getting a response back based on that chat history. Now, this is something that I go into in a lot more detail in No Code MBA's Building Apps with AI course, where we go into a lot of detail about how to build AI apps from scratch and set up all of these API connections. So if you're confused, you can definitely check out the link below and go to our full course to learn how to do that. But just know that we are connecting through Bubble's API connector here. And that is one way that you're able to get responses. Now, another plugin that I highly recommend checking out on Bubble is the ChatGPT Toolkit with Streaming plugin. And what this does is allow you to get streaming responses, meaning you're going to, kind of like as you see on ChatGPT itself, have the response come in a streaming format. So as opposed to having to wait for the entire response to load and then showing you that response, what this is able to do is show you the response as it's being generated, which is a better user experience in my opinion. So hopefully that was a helpful overview of how I built an AI SaaS without writing any code using Bubble. This is a fairly complicated app and it would take a very long time to go through how I built every part of it in detail. But hopefully you have an understanding now of what's possible with no code and AI, and hopefully it's giving you some ideas of what you could build yourself. I built this completely alone using Bubble and OpenAI, and it's something that you could definitely learn to build as well with some practice. So again, if you want to learn how to do this on your own, check out No Code MBA's Building Apps with AI course. You can go to the link below to go directly to it. And if you have any questions about this build, please leave a comment below. Otherwise, I will see you in the next video.